The rice terraces of the Philippine Cordilleras are located 350 kilometers from Manila, approximately a 9-hour drive. Situated in the northern part of the Philippine Luzon Island, among towering mountains whose altitude reaches up to 3,000 meters, they are reputed to be true stairways to heaven for their breathtaking view. In 1995, UNESCO inscribed the Ifugao rice terraces in the World Heritage List as a living cultural landscape. These 2,000-year-old rice terraces are a testament to the ingenuity of the Ifugao people, displaying a remarkable harmony between human labor and nature. Unfortunately, migration to urban areas, coupled with a weakening community-based tradition to preserve the rice terraces, has contributed greatly to its continuous deterioration. And in 2001, the rice terraces ended up on UNESCO's World Heritage in Danger list.
The most problematic situation of the rice terraces happens during dry and wet season. During the dry season, the water is needed. Mm-hmm. And during the wet season, most of the typhoons run across Ifugao province. So the terraces are destroyed. The funds will be needed constantly every year to strengthen these stone walls.
It was in response to these circumstances that the E8 Ifugao-Ambangal Mini Hydro Project was initiated in 2006. The project was a close collaboration between the E8, the Philippine Department of Energy, and the provincial government of Ifugao. The E8 is a non-profit organization consisting of leading electric power companies from G8 countries, which have come together to promote their views and positions on climate change, along with other major energy issues. On behalf of the E8, the Tokyo Electric Power Company Incorporated, or TEPCO, assumed responsibility for the Ifugao-Ambangal Mini Hydro Project. The objective of the project was to construct a 200-kilowatt mini hydro power plant at a site in the Kiangan municipality of Ifugao province. The power generated will be sold to a local electricity distribution cooperative. The resulting revenue proceeds will go to the Rice Terraces Conservation Fund. Another objective of this project was to showcase regional vitalization through indigenous renewable energy usage while promoting sustainable mini hydropower development.
Japanese has same culture, similar culture. Japanese also has rice terraces. Then Ifugao has rich hydro resources. For hydropower, also we need stable water river flow.
In May 2007, the project feasibility study concluded with the following points. First, estimates revealed that the maximum output of plant operations should be achievable 9 out of 12 months of the year, with sales totaling 1,443 kilowatts per hour. This will account for nearly 20% of the province's annual electricity consumption. Second, after deducting operation and maintenance costs, a net annual income of approximately $65,000 would be allocated for the Rice Terraces Conservation Fund. And third, the project posed no significant danger to the nation's ecological system or the province's indigenous culture. One of the key factors that contributed to the project's success was extensive consensus-building efforts. Meetings and consultations were conducted in conjunction with feasibility studies in order to obtain broad understanding and support from the local stakeholders.
Ordinary people here, the local people of Ifugao, they have no idea what the hydropower is. So why the social preparation is needed is proper understanding of the hydropower, how generate the electricity, and how linked to the that hydropower development for the conserve the life terraces. We have to understand the local people for the very clear, and if they could understand properly, the mini hydropower is not so big big affected to the peoples. So we conducted many consultations at the barangays.
In July 2008 in Manila, a cooperation memorandum of agreement was entered into between the Philippines Secretary of Energy, the provincial governor of Ifugao, and the project manager of E8. In December 2008, a local company named Alfalfa was selected for the construction work. A groundbreaking ceremony was held at the construction site, where a traditional ritual blessing was pronounced by the local priest in favor of the project's prompt implementation. The civil construction commenced at the beginning of 2009 and was completed in October of the same year. Much of the civil construction work took place under mountainous geographical conditions that made the use of heavy machinery very difficult. As a result, majority of the civil work was carried out manually. Gravel, cement, and other cumbersome construction materials were transported without the use of any modern delivery equipment. During peak busy periods, over 180 workers were mobilized daily. Since the construction site lies along a steep river valley, which is subject to frequent typhoons and torrential rains, the physical security risk of workers slipping and falling into the valley or being injured by falling stones was a major concern. Hence, mitigation measures such as enforcing the wearing of helmets and other safety gear equipment, as well as the hiring of a local safety officer, were implemented. The civil construction was divided into five parts. Number one, the intake wire and settling basin. Number two, the head raise and head tank. Number three, the penstock and spillway. Number four, the powerhouse. And number five, the transmission line. Water is received from the Ambangal Brook at the intake wire. The settling basin stops the water flow en route to enable suspended sediment to settle before the flow is again discharged into the head raise. The head raise consists mostly of open channels. Even during the construction periods, strong typhoons sometimes swept through the region, causing a few landslides. To prevent future damage and washout from such future avalanches, a portion of the head raise was covered and placed out of harm's way by setting it up on a constructed bridge. The head tank is a pond-like structure located at the top of the penstock to regulate water flow fluctuation. After being channeled through the head raise, the water flow is dropped through a penstock from a 63.5 meter effective head height, resulting in the generation of electricity. To avoid any surface alteration of the landscape of the nearby rice paddies, the penstock consisting of 500 millimeter diameter PVC pipes was embedded underground. These PVC pipes weigh over 200 kilograms each and were manually installed one by one. The powerhouse was constructed at the Ambangal Brook riverbed. Its roof serves as the ground floor for the work area and a traditional hut that was installed as a rest area for operators. During the last stage of the civil construction work, the turbine, generator, and control panel were installed. These pieces of equipment, appreciated and recommended for their compactness and easy maintenance, were delivered from Japan. A 1.8 kilometer transmission line was constructed to connect the power plant to the existing local grid. In September, a five-month training program was started for future plant operators under the collaborative authority of TEPCO, the Department of Energy, and the provincial government of Ifugao. At the program's end, the best six trainees were chosen to be hired by the province. Thus, the project did not only create a few local jobs, It was also instrumental in transferring hydroelectricity know-how to the local community. Alongside the ongoing civil construction, several meetings and consultations involving the provincial government were held to deliver the institutional framework of the project, including management guidelines governing power plant operations and the conservation fund. In accordance with Philippine law, the consent of those native inhabitants who might be affected by the project was also secured. During the final stages, a public information campaign was launched to promote the Rice Terraces Conservation Fund. In mid-January 2010, an inauguration and handover ceremony was held in both Manila and Ifugao. The Manila ceremony was co-hosted by the Department of Energy and TEPCO on behalf of E8. The event was honored by the attendance of Canadian and Japanese ambassadors, as well as by other distinguished guests. It concluded with the signing of a deed of donation between the Secretary of the Department of Energy and the TEPCO chairman. The inauguration ceremony in Ifugao took place a couple of days later. The event was led by the Assistant Secretary of the Department of Energy and the Ifugao Provincial Governor, and was attended by over 300 villagers. In January 2010, Ifugao-Ambangal Power Plant's commercial operations began. After a two-year monitoring period, which will end at the close of 2011, the ownership of the power plant will be fully transferred over from the Department of Energy to the Ifugao Provincial Government.
We are very fortunate because of the assistance coming from E8 and the Department of Energy and the cooperation of the communities in Kiangan. We will be having our first mini hydro project in Ifugao. No? This mini hydro project will benefit the province as a whole because we will be selling electricity to our electric cooperative. At the same time, because of the sale of this electricity, we will also have funds to preserve our world famous Ifugao rice terraces. Let's hope and pray that it will be in operation for many years to come.
Now that the Ifugao-Ambangal Mini Hydro Project has been completed, the local community can benefit from a reliable and sustainable supply of domestic electricity.
We want to cultivate a sense of ownership with every members of the community. We want them to own the facility. In that sense, they should develop some sort of cooperation in the maintenance, in the operation, as well as to in taking care of this mini hydro facility. They should not look at the mini hydro facility alone. They should always look at the greater vision that we have imparted to them, and that is energy, environment, and historic places can simultaneously and collaboratively exist within one project.
Moreover, it is hoped that this project's success will be a wake-up call to action that will attract wide international support for the preservation of the Ifugao Rice Terraces for future generations.